100 plus nothing does not equal 105.
Yes.
You cannot, interest, prior to 1694, interest carried the death penalty, anyone who charged or received interest.
In England?
In England and Europe, yeah. And that was 1694 is when the Bank of England began, which the charter of the Bank of England was. See, wars, most of the European wars were, they're all royal families and they're all related and they're arguing with each other over territories and countries, like Captain Cook didn't discover Australia. They knew where it was, he just had to come out and measure it up.
I believe it was in fact visited by others. People from other nations knew of its existence.
Absolutely, and there are stories that Solomon came to Australia with gold, looking in, there's lots of places around where there's Egyptian hieroglyphs, like boomerangs were known in Egypt thousands of years before the Aborigines came here, about 1000 AD.
I was in fact talking to an Aboriginal tribe in far northern Queensland a few years ago who told me that they had Egyptian artefacts.
Yep.
Being an inquiring mind type of person, I asked if I could see them. I needed permission from tribal elders, which I haven't gotten yet. But yes, I understand what you're saying.
Yes. You will find on my site a history of a lot of that under Australia is one of the categories on the site.
LarryHannigan.com.
Yes. HANNIGAN. Yeah. But getting back to the corruption side of it, well, corruption, what is corruption? Is theft, deceit, murder, all the things. And it all gets back to it is a spiritual battle which we are in. And if you look at, as Paul says, we wrestle not with flesh and blood, but
principalities
and high. Well, what on earth are those? Well, if you don't believe in God, well, I can't help you, but I don't believe we are an accident, and there's arguments about all the different gods, and there's only one, the Creator, who we, his proper name is Yahweh. And so who are these principalities and powers? Well, from about the time of 1611, when King James Bible was translated, many books were quietly removed, so we don't know a lot of those things. But the Book of Enoch, which is rubbish and downgraded, etc., well, Jesus quoted from it, Luke quoted from it, and Paul quoted, large amounts of Paul's writings are lifted, copied and pasted straight out of Enoch. Now, I'm not saying Enoch is, it's not in the canon, but there's lots of books. So, for example, I learned a lot about Alexander the Great. Now, there is no mention whatsoever of Alexander the Great in the Bible.
And he would have dated back to around 300 BC.
300 BC.
Yes.
Now, because he's not in the Bible, does that mean he didn't exist? Well, unfortunately, he does exist very much in the Bible, because he created, designed the Koine Greek language of which the New Testament was written in.
Koine
being? K-O-I-N-E. It was a military language and it's super, super accurate. That was his. And as a result, the Roman world, even though the official language was Latin, it's merged every educated. And people wonder, well, why did the apostles write in Greek? Because it was the most accurate common language at the time. I won't go into the construction of the language, but anything that Alexander wrote or spoke had only one interpretation. It was very clear. And unfortunately, today's Bibles have been doctored and neutralized, and large chunks have been removed. In my opinion, the NIV is probably one of the worst, but even the New King James is nearly as bad, with not so much what they, well, they have certainly changed words, but they've left out large chunks. So how does this corruption happen? It only happens for one simple reason, and that is because of a faulty money system where usury is involved. As I said, 100 plus nothing does not equal 100 plus interest. How can a person borrow money and pay back more than what exists? And everybody today is scratching around looking for money, not because they're greedy necessarily, but because it just cannot be. Inflation, like in tax in Australia in 1920, was about 2.5%. Today, whether you believe it or not, or calculate it, even if you don't pay tax, you are still paying roughly 80% of people's income is now in tax. And what is that tax for? Well, in the past, it was the king or the dictator or the emperor or Caesar wanted to live a good lifestyle. And but what does God say about taxation? He says, you give 10% of your increase. What is increase? Well, increase can only come from nature, such as you plant a grain of corn, you get 500 extra. That is increase. Farmers have increase. Fishermen have increase, animal breeders have increase, people who grow trees for timber, they have increase. But if I give you $50 to mow my lawn, that is not income, that is payment for labour.
So you're referring to taxation being a percentage of increase, not income?
God says you give 10% of your increase. There's no the ATO has no definition for income.
Australian Taxation Office.
The ATO. Now, when you get your little return and they say, what is your income? And like a fool, you write your wages. Your wages, nothing to do with it. My only increase that I have is some cabbages and some chickens and some vegetables that I grow. And then you've got to ask the next question, well, what happens to that money? Is it, oh, you've got to run the government. The government needs the money to run the country. That is also a lie. And that's very easily shown by the way the Nullarbor Railway was built.
The Nullarbor being in the Australian outback, for those who aren't
heard of it. Adelaide to Perth.
Yes.
Yeah, huge, long. It was all built tax-free, debt-free, because what was happening, they want to build a railway or a bridge or anything. Question one, do we know how? Question two, do we have the materials? Question three, do we have the manpower who is able to feed the men who build the road or the bridge while they're building it? Yes, we do. Well, no reason we can't build it, is there? But what about the money? We can't have, what's that got to do with it? Under that period when it was built, money was printed to match the increase in wealth. If you have a property with nothing on it and you build a house, does that make that more valuable, more desirable? If you go into a road, well, the first question you ask, we're going to build a road, why? Because it makes life easier. No other reason to build a road. You don't build a road to use up gravel or to create jobs. Creating jobs, nobody wants a job today, they just want the money. People talk about, oh, we'll go back to nature and we won't have any mining and we won't have any of this. I said, what are you going to make your shovels out of?
Yes.
So all those things are essential. But the money thing is, then while there is a shortage of money, people who are unscrupulous will do anything to get it by a deceit. And we've got numerous examples of that in politics and particularly in local councils, where a lot of people go in with noble intentions and good ideas, politics and council in particular. They're going to fix things and make it nice. When they get in there and they find the bribes that are offered, the opportunities. We had our local council up here last year auctioned 11 properties. One of those properties was auctioned for $2,100.
Mm-hmm.
There was another one, a place with market value around $300. Went for 120. Some councillor's brother-in-law would have got that. I've seen situations here where roadworks and that are done. By the way, don't think you pay cap. Councils don't fix roads. Every year the federal government charges us 38 cents a litre for fuel tax.
Just yes.
Fuel tax.
Yes.
Now that's about $45 billion a year in Australia. And according to the RACQ New South Wales, they spent about 25 on roads. Where's the rest?
Yes.
All these lame duck organisations and ideologies and forcing their beliefs on the... If you want to be Buddhist, gay, Catholic, atheist, whatever, that's fine. That's your choice. But don't try and legislate and force it onto the rest of us. That's my thinking.